three-pronged approach, how you as an innovator can break out of your comfort zone, go the extra mile, and simply blow away the status quo. All three of these letters begin with the letter R, so make them easier for you to remember. And watch out now, because I will be quizzing you on these along the way, okay? I used to be a school teacher, so hope you can do your homework. All right, what are these three words? Three words to remember. The first one is recognize. I need to categorize and understand the nature of changes that come into my life. Secondly, resolve. That involves balancing a couple of qualities that seem to be contradictory to each other. There's both an active and a passive aspect to this that we'll touch on in just a few moments. The third word is respond. What am I going to do with the knowledge that I've gained? What's my takeaway? I plan to give you three practical suggestions when we get to that point. All right, let's review these three words. Now, I know it's a relatively small audience and you guys just finished eating and that's fine, but I would really like to get some audience participation. So let's see if you know these three words. What's the first word? Recognize. What's the second word? Resolve. What's the third word? Very good. Boy, you guys are sharp. Ronald Pitzer, family sociologist at the University of Minnesota, once quoted a wise college student as saying, "For how I am, shame on my parents. If I stay that way, shame on me." Okay, that's a little bit of an oversimplification, but you know, I see just a little bit, at least some truth to that, right? I mean, while we can argue perhaps that we're a product of our own environment, still, I think it's up to us to go beyond the so-called blame game, rise to the challenge, and say, "I'm not just a puppet on the string, okay? I refuse to be an antagonist for change. I will be a catalyst for change and thereby facilitate innovation."